Good morning, and welcome to your daily Farm and Home Show, brought to you by the University of Kentucky Cooperative Extension Service. And now, here's your host.
Good morning, I'm Joanna Coles, and welcome to your Farm and Home Show. This morning, we're visiting with Dr. Ric Bessin. He's with the University of Kentucky Extension Entomologist there. Good morning, Ric.
Good morning, it's great to be here.
Well, I'm glad you're here because, you know, just like a normal Kentucky spring, the weather's been all over the place.
I'm not sure I know what a normal Kentucky spring is.
I would agree, but it had a lot of our corn farmers concerned. You know, they weren't able to get the corn in the ground as early as they normally did, and corn planting date, how does that play into insects?
Corn planting date has an incredible impact on the types of insects you're likely to see show up. So, you know, in a year where you could plant very early, we worry about some of the pests that attack the seed and the seedling since they're slow to germinate and emerge. You know, this year, because we had such delayed planting, there's another group of insects that we're worried about. And, you know, some of the fields may be protected with some of the traits in corn, but I think it's good to keep an eye out for some of these. And so there's a number of things that people need to be looking out for now.
Okay, and so what are some of the things that they look for first?
Well, just last week I had a couple of calls on armyworms. Mm-hmm. And so armyworms are showing up in some pastures and small grains. And when they finish feeding on pastures, and they may be moving to cornfields. And so people should be looking for armyworms already this year.
And so armyworms, even if it's nearby cornfields or just scouting, how would you recommend people do that, though?
Well, you know, they can attack pastures, they can attack small grains, and they can damage those on their own. And so people may need to protect some of those crops. The one call we had last week, you know, they were clipping the heads, you know, in small grains. And mm-hmm. so we can't tolerate that very much. In pastures as well, they can mow down the pastures. But when they finish these crops, you know, these partially grown to nearly full grown larvae tend to march out. I mean, that's why they call them army worms. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, you may get a significant amount of damage to the bordering areas right along the edge of some of these cornfields. And it may go, you know, 60, 100 feet or more into the cornfield.
And a lot of times when I've gotten calls, there's not a lot of pre-warning. It was, you know, I just was in that field and now I have a lot of it that's down.
Yeah, it's very typical to hear growers say, you know, I was in that field last week, it was thick, it was lush. I went in this week and there's hardly anything left. I mean, they can hit pretty hard, particularly when the weather is like this now. It's warm, mm-hmm. it's wet. Insects are going to develop quickly out there in the field. The key is for all these crops, particularly when they're small and in the seedling stage, is to scout at least on a weekly basis. Mm-hmm. Even if you think your crop is protected, it pays to scout. We were joking about it not being a normal year, but, you know, I've been here in Kentucky almost 30 years, and I haven't seen a normal year yet.
And don't expect one either. So definitely be on the lookout for that. Is there anything that we can do if we find armyworms?
There's a number of insecticides that provide very effective control. Mm-hmm. You know, the real challenge for growers is, particularly considering the grain prices as they are now, is when does it pay mm-hmm. to spray? And so going out there, evaluating those crops, and then using some of our decision guidelines that we have in our recommendations to determine whether or not it pays to spray. But we do, the sprays are effective.
So all good information. Now, besides the armyworm, are there any other insects?
Well, you know, since we have delayed planting this year, there's a number of insects that we need to be watching for as the summer progresses. Mm-hmm. You know, two that I think about quite a bit would be the corn borers, the European and Southwestern corn borer. Now, with traited corn, you know, things, the BT corns, the risk is extremely small mm-hmm. with those pests. But, you know, if we have some refuge corn or some non-BT corn, we really need to be watching that later on in the summer. Come this fall, or later on this summer, also fall armyworm can be a pest of late planted corn.
And so no matter corn planting time, no matter when it is, there's other and different insects that we might have to watch for depending on when that is.
Correct. So depending upon when we plant will determine what our risks are to insects later in the summer.
All right. Well, certainly appreciate the information. And if you have questions, make sure to contact your local extension office. Thanks for watching and have a great day.
If you have questions about today's topic, please call the Warren County Extension Office at the number on your screen. Thanks for watching and have a great day.